Hello, hello again, friends. Vlad here with more Assassin's Creed Valhalla news and a new video in which we'll discuss about birds. Not all birds in general, but a specific and iconic type of bird, the raven, or if you want, Eivor's raven. As usual, before we begin, thank you for your support on my videos, and if you could drop a like on this one as well, it would mean a lot. Last but not least, a small shout out to all new subscribers who have joined my channel, the latest being Damon Brown, Jake Nieder, I believe, Danny van der Zwag, Tinman and Danilo Germano. Thank you guys for joining and also for your support. Okay, so back to our raven now, and in this video we are going to cover several topics, including Eivor's raven connection with the Norse gods, the meaning of his name, his role in Assassin's Creed Valhalla, his abilities and more. So make sure you watch the video until the end, because I believe there is a lot to learn from it. Right then, so in order to make the whole video easier to follow, we are going to start with Eivor's companion name. According to a tweet from Ashraf Ismail, the creative director of Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and my favorite newsbringer by the way, Eivor's raven is named Swenin. Not Sinin, not Sinin, but Swenin. As you can see in the tweet, the developers wanted a name close to the term insight in Old Norse, and they kinda succeeded because sight is the translation for swenin. Now, you may wonder why a raven and not an eagle or a hawk or other type of bird, I don't know, a pigeon. The long answer short for this question is Odin. To better understand Ubisoft's decision and Swenin's name connection with Eivor and the Norse gods, let's backtrack a bit and see the companions we have used in the previous two Assassin's Creed games. In 2017, when Assassin's Creed Origins released, we got the chance to meet Bayek and his companion Senu. We can remember Bayek calling on Senu with a quote that is quite iconic, "Be my eyes, Senu." Senu's role in the game was very important. Bayek used Senu to scout areas, to hunt animals, or to harass and distract enemies. Because of the symbiotic relationship between them, Bayek's eagle vision was also transferred to Senu. Although there are more details about Senu, two things that we need to remember here are her name, because Senu was a female, and her species. Senu's name can be easily translated in sister, which basically denotes the connection she has with Bayek, and it is also linked to the word Bennu. Bennu, which was an ancient deity linked with the sun, creation and rebirth. According to the mythology, it looked like a heron. But the key aspect is that the Bennu bird was connected also with Ra, who is considered to be the most iconic solar deity that ever existed in all of ancient Egypt. According to Assassin's Creed Origins, Senu was an aspect of Bayek that would continue living on after his body died. Last but not least, Senu is a Bonelli eagle, which is considered to be an opportunistic predator. In 2018, Senu was replaced by Ikaros, the golden eagle we all loved in Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Unlike Senu, Ikaros was a male. We remember that Ikaros had the same abilities as Senu, meaning that Alexios and Cassandra used him to scout areas before engaging enemies, find specific objects such as treasure chests and collectibles, tag and distract enemies. While hunting, we can also see Ikaros swooping down and kill smaller animals. A major difference between Senu and Ikaros is that the latter was able to kill humans on his own. Ikaros was named after the son of master craftsman Daedalus. According to Greek mythology, Ikaros flew too close to the sun and fell to his death after the heat melted his wings made of wax. What is more important though is that Ikaros is also the eagle of Zeus, which is why Cassandra and Alexios are also known as eagle bearers. What we can learn from this is that in Assassin's Creed Odyssey, Ikaros shows the connection between our beloved assassins and almighty Zeus, the king of the Greek gods. Moving back to Assassin's Creed Valhalla and Swenin, let's start with the most common of questions. Why a raven? Before moving to mythology, it's worth pointing out that the ravens are considered to be unusually intelligent birds. The common ravens, like Swenin, played an important role in the Norse mythology. If you watch the Vikings TV series, you may remember that Ragnar Lodbrok has two tattoos on his head. Early in the series, those tattoos depict two ravens. Although we have discussed about how important the gods are in Assassin's Creed Valhalla in another video that I have linked in the description, we need to remember that the strongest connection Eivor has with the Norse gods is the one he has with Odin, which, as you can most likely guess, had two ravens, Hagin and Muni. They were sent to fly all over Midgard and bring information to the god Odin. Their names can be translated into thought and memory, while Svenin's name is translated into sight. In a recent interview, Ashraf Ismail announced that the Eagle Vision returns in Assassin's Creed Valhalla, but it will be known as Odin's sight. If we connect all the dots, we can clearly see why developers picked a raven for Assassin's Creed Valhalla. In Origins, we had Senu to connect Bayek with Ra. In Odyssey, Zeus was represented by Icarus, and in Valhalla we have Svenin, who serves as Odin's messenger. This leaves us with one final question: what can Svenin do, or what are Svenin's abilities? He will definitely retain the abilities from the previous games. We can use him to scout areas, tag enemies, find treasure chests and collectibles. However, I believe he will not be able to kill enemies. Harass and distract them, yes, but not kill them, because we have to remember that Svenin is a raven after all, and due to its size it will be quite impossible. One new feature that Svenin will bring to Assassin's Creed Valhalla is the ability to steal. I remember Ashraf Ismail mentioning that this, but I wasn't able to find the source anymore. If this is the case, then we can expect to see Svenin stealing important things such as quest items, keys, letters, and small items in general, but not heavy stuff such as weapons and armor. It would be interesting to use Svenin as a thief, definitely, and I can see this happening, but what about Odin's sight or the Eagle Vision? How will this work, since developers confirmed that along with our trusty Raven, a return to the roots of Eagle Vision is also expected? I believe that this will be possible in specific areas only. If you remember, in Assassin's Creed Odyssey, while exploring a cave, for example, Icarus could not be used to scan the area for chests or to tag enemies. Hopefully, Ubisoft is going to fix this by bringing back the Eagle Vision as it was in the previous games, when we are able to scan surrounding areas and see enemies and other items of interest. So, tell me, what do you think about Svenin? Is it a good fit in your opinion? Do let me know in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe for more Valhalla news and breakdowns. And until next time, stay safe.